you have seen, I've been including some cool shots in the last videos of the channel.
These shots were possible thanks to a very cool device that I've designed and built from scratch.
As you may have seen in the title, today I'm gonna show you the Architects3DP SLIDE. This is the fourth iteration of the camera slider we started developing in some videos in last year.
These images are from previous videos of the slider that have their own videos in our channel. In case you wanna check them out, you'll find the links down in the description.
This time, the slider is much smooth, silent, and smart than ever. With this new version, you will be able to control it from your phone via Wi-Fi, choosing between 4 different speeds and even make pan shots,
well to focus a subject, or well to capture a panorama.
In this video, I'm gonna show you how to build it from scratch, and I will include down in the description
the links for the bill of materials, where you'll be able to buy all the necessary components to build your own Architects3DP slide from Amazon,
while supporting my YouTube channel, Architects3DP.
You'll also be able to download the firmware and all the necessary STL files to print for the build.
If you don't own a 3D printer, you can contact me by email at architects3dp@gmail.com
and check if I can print them and send them to you.
Have in mind that I live in Spain, so if you live in Europe, it will be easier than if you, for example, live in the US. As I said before, for the build,
we'll need a set of 3D printed components that I've designed and some hardware components that we'll have to buy.
Please notice that to get access to the STL files,
you have to be a Patreon supporter of Architects3DP.
I'm saying this because I received a comment in a video this week, that you can read here on screen, that literally says that he appreciates my work but he's not paying for the files. Well, the reality is that to post regularly good quality videos takes, trust me, a lot of time. Time and effort that I have to take from my sleep.
For example, have a look at the timeline of the review of the EZ3 Dora 3D printer. It has a crazy amount of work invested.
Furthermore, the channel has right now
more than 4,000 subscribers and almost 300,000 views.
And do you know how many Patreon supporters it has?
It has 16, that's it, 16.
I've been sharing my knowledge on YouTube for 1.5 years for absolutely free, but the reality is that I have to eat, pay for my expenses, pay for the components and the 3D printers you see on the channel, etc.
And I'm getting, for example this month, $51.
And that's thanks to my very loyal Patreon supporters that are appearing here on screen. Trust me that I'm really motivated from the positive comments I'm receiving on my videos from you guys, but life is expensive and I lose some motivation when I read this kind of comments. I'm gonna try to keep improving my YouTube channel, bringing more quality and quantity of videos, so please consider, if you can and you think it's fair, to become a Patreon supporter, not just for getting the files for the builds, but also for supporting all my work. Okay, so I'm gonna stop talking about this subject, and I'm gonna start with the assembly of the best DIY motorized camera slider. But before, as a summary of the best features,
basically this part is the carry that moves the camera with 8 wheels, and run through these 1 meter V-slot aluminium profiles.
The pan movement is controlled
by this aluminium rail and the device I've designed in the bottom of the carry. And all the movement is controlled via Wi-Fi from my phone, with this webpage I've designed inspired by the video uploaded by Dustin Vang. Basically, we send the instructions from our phone to this Wi-Fi node that sends the signal to the NEMA 17 stepper motor on here on the other side.
The Arduino is powered
by this little 5V battery
that you can get for very cheap to charge your phone.
And the motor is powered by this external 12V power supply.
If you want to make it 100% portable,
you can use a 12V battery instead,
that I will link in the bill of materials just in case. By the way, if you like this project, remember to subscribe to Architects3DP on YouTube and turn on the notification bell to get an alert every time a new video is uploaded. Okay, so at this point that we know the basics of the Architects3DP slide,
we're gonna start with the build. We'll focus the build in 3 critical points basically. They will be the extreme with the motor, that will go mounted right here, the extreme with the electronics, which will house them here, and will be covered with this nice looking sliding tab. And finally the carry that will move back and forth through the V-slot rails, to which we are going to add a set of different 3D printed components that we'll see later. These 3 parts will be mounted more or less in this position, but before we're going to add to them all these other components, that as you can see are quite a lot, so let's get started!
By the way, I have to mention that this project has been possible in part Architects to Sakata 3D.
They have provided a different set of materials that I'm gonna be using in some builds, and you will also see in my coming post on Instagram. Sakata 3D is one of the few filament manufacturers that produce their complete line of materials in Europe, concurrently here in Spain.
So definitely one of the companies that you can always rely.
For this project, I've used their PLA 850 Quartz, that is a very reliable filament for the big parts.
And I've also used the Orange PETG
for the parts that need to be more resistant, like knobs and camera mounts.
I've been testing some of their materials, and I strongly recommend you to check them out
through their website sakata3d.com, where you will find the shop and more information.
So now we're gonna start building the end where the motor is located. For that, we'll need this set of components.
For 3D printed components, we'll need the motor block, two legs, 2 feet, and 2 knobs. For regular hardware, we'll use 2 M5x40mm hex bolts, 2 M5x25mm hex bolts, and 4 M5N nuts. Also for special hardware, we'll use an M17 stepper motor, a GT2x16 teeth pulley, and 2 2-wire cables.
Alright, so once said, I'm gonna start with the build.
For now, we'll pick up the 3D printed block, the NEMA 17 stepper motor, the pulley, the 4 washers, the 4 bolts, and for tools, the Allen key to tighten the pulley, and the screwdriver, that in my case I'm gonna be using this electric one. Okay, so the motor is gonna go mounted here in this position, facing the cables we previously installed in place through these holes. Later, before the assembly, we're gonna completely pass them through the aluminium profile to reach the electronics on the other side. So we'll put the motor in place and we're going to connect the cables, so they will help keeping it in the gap meant to hold it. Now we'll flip the whole assembly and we're gonna put the 4 washers in place. Once in, we'll insert the 4 bolts and we will tighten them in, till we have a solid build. Last step with the motor will be to install the pulley, that we are going to install more or less at this height, and we'll be able to modify it later.
All the functional parts are installed, and we are going to add an extra feature that I didn't announce before.
So we'll pick up the build, the 2 legs, feet and knobs, 2 M5x40mm hex bolts, 4 M5N hex nuts, and 2 M5x25mm bolts, and we're going to assemble everything together. To assemble it, the first is gonna be to insert the long bolts inside the knobs. You can add some glue if you want before you insert them, so they will stay in forever. Next, we'll mount the feet in the short screws. You can do the same with the glue. Once we have them, we'll put a hex nut inside the leg like so. Once again, you can glue them down, so they will stay there forever. Once done, we'll screw the foot on the leg like this, all the way till the end. We'll repeat this process in the other leg as well. And once we got it, we're going to insert the 2 hex nuts that we have left inside the motor block through these holes, as you can see right here. Once ready, we'll pick up a leg assembly. With this uneven surface facing to the block, we'll pass a knob assembly throughout, and we'll screw this whole assembly through this hole right here. Same process with the other leg. And once we have both of them inserted, we're gonna tighten the knobs till the end. As you can see, we'll be able to fold the legs like this, or put them in operating position, just rotating the knobs. By the way, this is the real operating position. Alright, so that's been everything for the motor end. Here we have it. And now we're gonna insert the cables through the aluminium B-slot profile as I announced before. All the way through. Then we'll insert the other profile as well. The motor end is complete, and now we're gonna jump to the carry. This block that is gonna be moving our camera through the slider. To start, we'll need the 3D printed carry, 8 M5N hex nuts, 8 M5x30mm bolts, and the 8 V-slot wheels. To install each of the wheels, we'll first insert the wheel in place through this part in the middle. Then insert the screw from the exterior, and last component, the hex nut that will insert from the interior like this. You can align it, for example, using a screwdriver, and once it's in place, we'll tighten the screw using our electric screwdriver. Alright, so once we have it, this will be our carry. But now we need to install some more components that will allow us to make the pan movement with the camera. So we'll pick up the camera mount that is gonna make the pan movement. Then that's the piece that closes the camera in place. This will transfer the movement from the linear rod to the camera mount. Finally, the bashing. For hardware, we'll also need an M8x22mm hex bolt, an M6x12mm bolt, an M4x8mm screw, a 608ZZ bearing, and a 525ZZ bearing that I have already inserted in here. Next, an M8N nylock nut, as well as an M6N nut that I've inserted right here, an M8W washer, and finally one of these M6W auto-locking washers.
Alright, so as always, once we have all the components ready, I will start with the assembly of this part, but I'm gonna do that in the second part of this project, since this one is getting too long and I don't have more time this week for the video. Remember that down in the description, you will find the link to download the bill of materials, the firmware, and all the necessary STL files for the build. Finally, I just wanted to ask you to subscribe to Architects3DP if you still haven't. Hit the like button, leave a comment, and share this episode so more people will be able to enjoy with the new projects. And as always, a special shout out for my Patreon supporters for making this channel possible. If you want to join them and support the channel as well, you can do it navigating to patreon.com/architects3dp or clicking here in the top right corner. Okay guys, so as always, see you in the next video.